artists Trust from these essences and as an artist, I see it as an interesting feedback of what I think and what I think I want to realize. So the whole idea of holding it, what it has some sort of history, apart from drawing from the cultural wealth of the nation, there are a lot of histories surrounding the idea of holding it, and we all know about the Nollywood movie. Most of all, when you have the basic Google on Nigeria or Africa, you have at least a page or two popping up on Nollywood, which is the film culture. So the Nollywood film culture basically is comparable to the Bollywood, which is just next door to Europe and Asia, and equally the Hollywood, which is more of the American movie industry. And again, that has influenced a whole lot of other woody sort of contents. You know, you have Bollywood from Ghana, you have Hollywood from Kenya, and it just keeps all the wood together. You know? So, absolutely. So these are some of the dynamics for the kind of ethos, this sort of interesting background to what I'm going to explain to you in terms of experimental video art. Now, talking about experimental video, I can say consciously we have some interesting activities that emulate specifically 1995, 1997, when the Nigerian artist Olamide Bawumia, based in the United Nations, in the UK, basically, so based in the United Kingdom, London, made it back home. And he made a documentation of his visit. And he reflected, he stayed away for so long. And this was the beginning of somebody dealing with something that is out of that usual context of a conventional film structure. And it has also reflected how we understood the environment, particularly letters. And again, there were a lot of activities within the university town of Nsukka. I know most of you are quite aware of El Menashe, the African artist, and one of the renowned visual artists in the world. So within the university town of the University of Nigeria, Nsukka, one of his students, one of El Menashe's students, also the gentleman Erasmus Onishi, was already experimenting with some video materials through in this work. Erasmus is a sculptor. He works more with wood. But again, it's interesting how he discovered the idea of moving image, possibly documenting the process of his work or looking at things around, I mean, within the context of sculpting, painting, drawing, and all that. So this paint, or this video, which was produced in the HS format, also reflected some of this interesting boundary between sculpture, painting, and experimental video work. And he presented this in an exhibition called New Energies in 2011. New Energies was a collective of students, artists, that we are mostly from the University of Nigeria, Super, mostly influenced by the Elementary School of Thought, and also who were interested in trying out other forms of materials aside from the conventional materials. Now, video art. We cannot talk about video art again in isolation, understanding that there are interesting activities, cultural activities within the system where it's trying to exist. And also understanding the rich film industry, particularly in Hollywood. So the whole idea of video art was quite interesting to be assimilated as a form of practice from 2007. But we have since a workshop that the one is foundation based in Amsterdam. After that, we have a couple of workshops at the Center for Contemporary Art in Lagos and also at the University of Nigeria. So, that day, it's like something very interesting was about to happen. Several workshops followed, and I was part of a particular one in 2009, which is Lina Imaginary. And Lina Imaginary was a workshop given by two interesting gentlemen, Nate Bordelay, a Cameroonian artist, and another gentleman from Brazil, Stanley Lewis, a photographer who lives in Diamantina, very interesting city. an active date of this TV, 2011, or thereabout. And also, an unknown party based in Amsterdam, Miguel Pechkowski. The three gentlemen were in Lagos for about 2 weeks and began an intensive workshop for experimental yoga. I was part of that workshop. And at the end, we thought it was important and it was time for us to start with something that could nourish more experience from this series of workshops. And it was at that point that we found the video art network. With two other colleagues, a lady who is a partner, who is a graduate producer, and who was also an administrator or facilitator of some of the workshops, and a sound artist, a member of the Social Power of Vienna, and right now of the residency project, of the Dow residency project in Berlin, Germany. So the three of us started this network, and the idea was to create a new platform for young people to begin. Without any sense of, you don't have to think it's necessary. It's just experimental. Play with it as much as you want and see how it impacts on your understanding and how it expands your creative scope. So we started that and we were able to also incorporate our personal practices and also see how our personal interests help in expanding both the discourse and the quality of work, the quality of interaction, and all that. Over the years, we have really had other organizations like the Movement Institute, the African Artists Foundation, the Center for Contemporary Art Lagos, and a couple of individual organizations support some of our programs. It's really a difficult situation, and it's not as easy as it sounds, or as I'm trying to make it sound. But it was an interesting engagement for us to see how far we can go with our basic intent and where have we taken risks. Other times, we also encourage artists working with other forms of traditional materials to see how they can engage and radio art in different dimensions. I've worked with the Italian, which is also the exhibition in the Lagos High Curated, and it was important to see how we incorporated video art, performance art, into his conventional works, drawing, painting, and photography. The video art network legs, basically, we just try to see how we can bring a new vibration, create some new vibration, or create some sort of new content within the artistic landscape of the city. And we never mistake to regain more dimensions than we need. Make sure that there is some sense of liberty in artistic reasoning, artistic engagement, artistic realization, and also how people appreciate art. So, over the years, we have really tried to bring this energy, this fresh energy to young people. And I'm also personally energized by this activity. We've had our challenges, we've had our very tough times, and it's important also understand these aspects. And but most importantly, no matter what challenges are, I think we are quite dedicated in surpassing that. And the number of few of the challenges we had was some of our institutions completely telling us to the face that they do not have facilities for video art presentation. They do not understand what we are doing, the meaning in the second, in 60 seconds, in 1 to 5 minutes, or in 10 minutes of a video work. So it was really difficult to get them to understand how abstract art can equally reflect in a video work, and how you can say so much in a very short period of time, and how you can contextualize your artistic idea without it taking a two or three dimensional form. So they really love the idea of running wool and they love the stones of running wool, but they didn't really buy the idea of experimental video or sound. And they thought it was completely Western, it was inappropriate for our cultural mentality. They are well aware of what it is against them. But we are also happy to continue with our engagement and presentation to see how we can change that cycle. And we learned before, most of the arts were basically, all the arts schools do not have a media to experimental media art program. So it was a big problem talking to young students about using materials from their programs, using footages from any other, aside from making photographs or making a lens film. How do you appropriate the evidence that you also acquired to this particular material panel? How do you bring the technology based art into your research? So we have a lot of problems, but again, we have people that are open to receiving the new information and we are able to leverage into that. And because we noticed that sense of consciousness and interest, so we decided to build a sort of network and collaborative structure. So we decided to partner with people, individuals. We talk to friends, we get them to understand our perspective. We get them to talk to their friends or their other colleagues who run some sort of organizations, and eventually we were invited to share our thoughts with them, and eventually we were given some minimal spaces. Actually, they just leave you in the corridor or the lobby or the rooftop, or some days that you don't really have to interfere in the basic activity. But we were happy to draw most of their visitors and friends and collaborators to our little trip and special space. So we were happy that they gave us these invitations and we were happy to ride again. And the CCA, particularly with this cylinder, has been very fundamental in us realizing our intent of giving more possibilities through video for artists to work with. And again, the Goethe Institute and a whole lot of other cultural organizations spread around the city. In 2015, we made a very bold decision and to get video art into the university system. And because we were so happy with collaborators and friends, we were able to convince the head of the department and we were able to draw up the curriculum. And we were able to create this course content for 100 level of fresh students that were coming to the university. And we ran this up from the first semester as an introductory course. And I think we had about 25 students who made a huge body of work throughout the course of the semester. The semester is about 4 months. So it was interesting to see them engage academically with the concept of video art as a virtual media. We built up several goals and objectives to help us to get to where we want to be and what we intend to achieve. And some of it include developing educational and public programs, screenings, workshops, and all that. And also curating programs and exhibitions on video art curriculum. And also creating a set of new media content through our website, through our blog support, our page on Facebook, our network of Instagram, everywhere we just try to see how we can get into virtual spaces and how we can get into people in different ways and in different dimensions. I'm going to take you through a series of images right now, and I think I'm speechless. And I'd like to share if you have any questions. I'm happy to explain some of the images, but I'm going to run them through, and I'm happy to engage with you any other way that you think. But before then, the materials are the same, the basic camera, the basic folder, and the process is equally the same. Those softwares are available and free. We have free existing softwares in your cameras so you can work with. The ideas are different. Of course, the solutions will come from any source, and that is the beauty of the, I mean, that is where the sort of the diversity. So, there's not strange about what we do, but we just try to see how we can create a new sense of energy, a new sense of interest, and see how young people mostly can adopt this and grow. So, I'm going to show you these are exhibitions we have over time, and some of these exhibitions have been held across the continent and in some other parts of Europe, the United States and the rest of the world. And I'm happy we're going to be having one here in a very short time. Identity and Imagine Space was the first
know, part of the Eastern Party in 2009 at the center of the Federal Athletics. And we had about 13, 12 participants from all over the world, including Ecuador. Yeah. So we had an artist from Ecuador, Vanina Padina, she's got an interesting name. So this was the first video, and it's also had a couple of weeks, and we had writers that we selected that contributed to the content. The new survey was a collaboration with several Nigerian artists over Nigeria's 50 years, and we invited these artists to reflect on the idea of independence and what they thought about the country after 50 years, and we encourage them to create in other dimensions aside from the traditional art process, painting, drawing, encourage them to create sounds, to collaborate with the rappers, to have performances, to create new video works that reflected on this. I'm sorry, the image is not that sharp. Look at the light. We also collaborated with a lot of fascinating international organizations on video art programs around the world. And I thought video art was the World International Video Art Day in 2010, and we were part of that celebration. Project Amplify was a selection by 25 curators from around the world on some video works that really reflected on certain issues that talked about our world. The conditions within the world. And we were happy to be part of this, and we screened these videos for about 25 days at the Center of Contemporary Art Levels. The supermarket project was sweeping, and we were happy to be part of this in 2011, and it brought us also gave us the opportunity to present experimental works from Nigeria and how we were engaging our social political realities. The media arts training held at the Lagos in 2011 was also an interesting platform for us to encourage visual artists to get involved and to work within the local context. And we were quite happy to connect other visual artists from Nigeria spread all over the world. And we are really happy to have our projects and programs and we look forward often to also create new programs together. It was a short interesting number of 2011 and it was an interesting time for us to also present a connection of a body of work that we made over time from 2007 to again 2011. Talking about workshops, what we do at Van Levels and High Secondary is to create educational programs for young people. And we don't only look at Levels, we look at every other space within the continent. We've had workshops in Brazil, we've had workshops in Sudan, University of Science and Technology, too, where this particular workshop happened for 2 weeks in collaboration with the University of Amsterdam. We've also had workshops in Accra, Ghana. And we've really talked to a lot of young people. We've got them interested in discussing local issues in ways that are more new, more engaging, more interesting, more deep in context, using video, photography, sound, and all that. We've also created a program with our local spaces to engage teachers. Just anyone that is interested in understanding the concept of experimental video format in media platforms. We've had school trainings and community intervention programs within Lagos and also beyond. This was a marketing project at Urban Fiber, and it was interesting to take our work to the interior villages, to communities that possibly didn't come in. It was really, really wonderful to see young kids being in place. They were aware all through the night, seeing something completely new, and also having a new form of vocabulary to describe their experiences. We had young photographers that after they resolved not to delete wastes or images they have had, but rather to put those images in a different context. So we really had a wonderful time in Mali and it was beautiful talking to young people who were there before, showing them a whole new perspective into creative reason and engagement. And this happened in Sikasso and in Sebu. We were also at the festival night in Kalapata, Greece, and we also have to present. We all work in different capacities as a collective on individual basis, from all perspectives, we just want to push our work to the rest of the world. So wherever we are talking to others about our practice and how we can also incorporate the collective into our individual engagement. So we have been to several exhibitions globally, and we try to also put the idea of the collective forward as we get involved personally. The Lagos Life Festival was a huge collaboration between artists from Germany, from whether I think it was even about 7 countries that went out of this project. And it was also interesting to see how most of them, you know, share context from their environment and how they engage in some of the processes, including public and our lenders. And for, I mean, for 3 days, it was a community and 6 days there. Still fighting flowers and intellectual property was a series of exhibitions on video art from Africa created by Zito Asani. Zito is a curator based in London from Lobe. Artists reflected about this all in the period of the workshop, and they created multiple works that reflect, I mean, within video experimental art forms, installation, video sound, performance, then we engage by advocating with these subjects, and the first presented their own engagement. We have interesting artists like Bernard Jackson from Ghana and for the Golden Lounge project, the collaboration between Vance and Visual Art Network South Africa and Picture, the Democratic Republic of Congo, and the Video Art Network Lagos. And what we did was collaborate with over 15 other organizations across the continent, and we, over a period of a week, made a simultaneous presentation of video works around the continent. Selected species also across Africa. And it was beautiful to see how people engage video works from other parts of the world presented to them in Lagos, and it just comes to the world in Nigeria. Nigeria celebrated its centenary in 2014. And 2014 is a very important year for us because it reflected a lot about our history, amalgamation of the country, and the evaluation of the country and the exile or the incursion of the colonialists. In 1897, the British ravaged the city and the Oba was sent in exile. In 1914, Nigeria was amalgamated in the North South and other territories. And these are important points in our history. So what we did was invite local artists to interpret the understanding of this important historical content. And we return back to the original city where this thing happened, which is the city. And we went back to one of the environments, which is the Eagle Street. Yeah, Eagle Street, where most of the artists that were making the, some of the bronze works for the kings and the fathers were painted back as far as 1897. So it was really interesting for us to get back to deal with this local people and also present our work in line with the handicrafts and some of the fabricated works, and also create a huge discourse around our political realities. Peter was part of that project and quite a good number of other parties that participated, including myself. involved several organizations, including the Best 56, led by Ron, and the support of Alia and the Bernard Foundation to really put up another workshop with artists from Georgia. And most of us are there, including myself and the local leader for our workshop starting on the 16th. And we hope that this will also be presented in another extended workshop in Lagos that is supported by the German Cultural Organization, funding organization, FW, who are also sponsoring the program in Lagos. I mean, it's really interesting how we want to connect. Being here in Georgia doesn't just simply stray the whole thing to Nigeria and Indonesia. I think we should also look at interested partners that want to collaborate or share in our engagement. And we have to create a way for them to have that platform to enjoy their community collaborating with us. So we are working with the German organization, and we're hoping in January, February, March, and the workshop and an extended exhibition will go in Lagos. And between most of the works produced from days will be part of that, and a huge platform that are coming with that project. So these are some of the programs for the time. And we're happy to also engage in different dimensions with photographers in the city. We just, before I came to Georgia, we had an exhibition running called the Lagos Open Range. The Lagos Open Range was also traveling to Balaku, and we have very young photographers working in a very different form and format, and Derek is one of them, and he's going to be part of this project too. So we're happy to see how they engage extensively with new processes, new materials, new ideas, and a lot is also coming out from several workshops. Documentary Dissonance was one of those workshops, and we're happy to work with some of these young people. There are a lot of actors that are helping these projects, so we don't just get them to think into, we don't get them to just share their basic ideas, we also make sure publications document our engagement. The Lagos photo party happened on the day I was flying to Georgia. And I was split between meeting Adia and Makun and having a party in Lagos. And I chose Indonesia. So I only got the Facebook reflection of what happened. This happens quarterly. And what we did is we created an interesting platform where music, party, photography, video, familiarity, friendship, food, everything all managed. And we do this at the rooftop of the Goethe Institute. And it's interesting how people from different backgrounds, cultural producers, scientists, anybody, just anybody and everybody, they want to be here, they want to see how it is, they want to enjoy the music, enjoy the food and the wine, they want to engage with the artists that are presenting, they want to buy the photographs of some of the works. It's really an interesting configuration of ideas and creative content that we put together. We have one of the most outstanding DJs in Nigeria playing at this party, actually, DJ Afrologic. And his music is always, always awesome. I thank him for that, actually. Yeah. And this is all far away. And this is all far away, and everybody just gave you a lot of happiness, actually. And I'm close up.